Alright guys, we are here at Youngstown Raceway Park. We decided to come out here and cruise around on the track with our friend Chris Knapp. Chris is actually going to take me out in his 240 in a second. I've never driven with Chris, but he is very good behind the wheel, and I'm really excited about this one. Also, we got the big dog's car out here. This thing's running a little weird right now. It doesn't have a proper amount of coolant. The brakes don't seem to be working.
The battery is taped.
Yeah,
Keep going.
The negative line for the battery is literally is hanging on by like two strands. It's ridiculous.
Sorry, my friend's making some obnoxious noises over there.
Yeah. And we're going to also bring Jim from the bike shop and put him in the car, and he's gonna be scared for his life, and we're so excited about this one. But first things first, I'm gonna get in the car with Chris. All right, so getting in the car with Chris for the first time ever. I've seen him drive before, he's really good. So this is gonna be a lot of fun, man. It's a perfect day to go cruise around the track, and we got a couple things in store, so let's start off with this one.
He will put you into a wall. Good luck, buddy.
Have fun.
That's the exact point I pooped myself last time. The exact point.
My God. That is terrifying.
I think it's just as scary looking at it.
Yeah.
Out of gas?
It was fun, man. Going into the turn where the wall is like so cool. Chris did awesome. Yes! Really, really good.
That was terrifying. We got
it. Ran out of gas. Round two.
Yep. My gas doesn't work.
If you got a gas gauge and it don't work, that's not good. Mine, surprisingly, after everything else doesn't work, my gas gauge worked great.
Your gas gauge still works?
Worked great.
Thank God. Car doesn't drive, but the gas gauge works.
Does it make you want Ricky's 240 back?
You know what, dude? It's always gonna be my 240, no matter what he does. Even though it doesn't look anything like it did.
So it's still gonna be my 240, man.
Still a stock 240 at heart.
It wasn't stock. Don't you dare.
What?
Did you make sure you hit that real good?
I made sure nobody's setting to see that real good. I kept my head against the seat.
Yeah, that's what me and Corey were just saying. You can't
no
be,
one's gonna know.
Can't
we
be
wrapping Sharpie Scotty on the back. Yeah,
block it out. If he's a tape over.
Let's blur it the whole entire time. You think he'd notice?
No, he would notice.
We're professional tire changers now after NASCAR.
Yes. That's a lot better than I can do.
He did a donut mid-run.
I can't do that. Maybe one day, baby. Maybe one day. Joke, like we're all sitting here, like my car's on. We're all like enjoying ourselves. We turn around, we're like,
oh, it's on fire.
Huh.
I hope you have your
turn that off. So, are you ready for your ride that you're about to endure?
Oh, yeah.
He's not ready.
Have you ever been
he
in drift
car? He wants to think he's ready, but he's not.
This is my first time ever seeing drift cars.
Nice.
Okay, what are you thinking while you're sitting here against the fence?
I'm thinking it looks pretty crazy. Should be fun.
Have you seen on TV and stuff?
Oh, yeah.
You watch on the internet?
Yeah.
You ever play any crazy like video game?
Hell yeah,
like,
I played them all.
me and Jim, we game together.
Played them all.
So you played all the drift games. So yeah. This should be a walk in the park then.
Yeah, it should be simple. No big deal. This is really no big deal.
So if you like this, is there any possible way I can get you to do a burnout in my car?
I'll gladly.
Very possible, yeah.
Maybe some donuts. Possible. I think I can get Jim to do some donuts today.
You show me the ways, I'll make it happen.
Jim is going to get in the car with Chris right now. He's going to put his life into Chris's hands. And you know, it's a good guy to put his life in the hands. I went for a ride and it went great. It went perfect, man. I had great enjoyment in that one. But you're about to go flying into this wall at about 40 miles per hour, you know, breaking loose. It's pretty much on control.
You're really about to do it right now.
You're just about to
Oh, like right now?
Yeah, like right this second.
Oh, wow.
Right now. Like, let's go to the car.
The walk of shame right
here
now.
Here it is right now.
Hobble over, fetal position.
Just remember, if the car catches on fire, you're a fireman. You know what to do.
Yes, that's true. Jim's a certified fireman. Ready for battle. Did you ever think that when you started working for Skycranners Bike Shop that you would like
skydiving and then drifting and then...
It's great. It's absolutely great.
Good at being retired.
There's a fire extinguisher in here somewhere.
I'll find it.
Pull this tab.
And that's the tab.
No, don't pull it. No. It'll eject you from the car.
Yeah, Top Gun type stuff.
Ejectocito, cuz.
Yeah, that what he said.
Ejectocito.
Hell yeah.
All right, get it.
All right, so Jim is in the car right now, and they are officially coming around the corner mid-drift any second now. And I can only imagine what's going through Jim's head. He's gonna try to play it cool. That's how Jim does it, but he's screaming in the inside.
Amazing, that was great. Absolutely great.
I saw you, man. You were applauding at one point.
Yeah, I saw it. I was like, yes.
You didn't know what to do.
It was so good.
That's so what awesome. Were you thinking when you came around the corner and you started sliding into that wall right there?
I went, oh man, this could be rough. But I have full confidence in this man.
It's good, right? Oh. It's crazy to see all the stuff he does with his hands though, right?
It's busy.
It's very busy in there.
Yeah, a lot more tutors than I thought, that's for sure.
Well, the thing is, we're going to try to get Jim to do a couple donuts. Going to try to take Jim and put him in the driver's seat just like we do with Maddie and Mike Scheinbach. This is going to be really cool to watch. So get ready, Jim. You better go watch some YouTube videos or something.
Yeah, but start now.
So last time we were here, Maddie drove Chris Knapp's car and he absolutely killed it. He's using clutch kicking only, and today I'm going to try to get him to do the e-brake, but I'm going to get him to do some donuts in my car so we can see how it feels. My car, you have to rev it a lot higher and get its weight to the moon before you can let it go. So you rev it really high, drop the clutch, and then it brakes loose pretty good. But once it's good, it's good. Good. Right now I'm gonna teach Maddie how to use the e-brake. It's pretty self-explanatory. You yank that thing up. But remember, whenever the e-brake is in, the clutch is in. All right, so you don't need to give it gas right now. We're gonna go back to the back track. I'm gonna show Maddie how to use the e real fast. And then after he figures it out and he feels confident with it, I'm gonna try to let him do the turn and see how he does. And you're gonna yank the e up and then put the clutch in and then just so you can feel how it feels. That's pretty good, right? Do you understand how it feels now, though? All right, so just go easy into it, and then just do what you did in Chris's car. But it's gonna feel a little different. If it feels like you're feeling weird, just smash your foot in the brake and hope for the best. You're good. That was pretty good. That was good. You got it sideways, and he started to slide. It's just hard to get the revs up to where they need to be. Chris's car, the revs, they come up quick because the turbo spools down low. This turbo spools up high. So you want to go into it more, so you don't cut off straight, but that was good though. That's good. See, the power is dying out on you.
You think I just need to rev it up more?
I think so, yes.
Should I go in a little faster?
No, if you come in fast and then you grip, you're done.
I'm so scared to put your car off of that at all. Like,
what?
Terrified. I'm terrified to hit it again because I don't want to shoot.
Well, you could go farther in a little bit.
You have to be hitting the gas while you're on the e-brake, huh?
Yeah, you're
pretty much. Like,
yeah. Oh, for sure.
So that's the thing. I won't hit the gas while I'm on the e.
You have to have the gas up, and then you have to be dropping the clutch.
All right.
That was way better. Way better.
That's the thing. It's putting in the e-brake and putting your foot on the gas.
No, for sure. It's weird.
You're the man. That was so good.
Damn it.
That was so good. It's so hard. That part that you got to is like, that's the hardest part. What you just hit. That was awesome. You want to try one more and then we'll go get gas? Yeah. I think we have enough gas. If it cuts out, it cuts out. But we'll give it one more and then we have to get gas. Yeah. That was awesome. You literally just did the turn. That was so good.
Brakes don't work at all, guys.
Brakes, not at
That's
all.
That's no joke.
No joke. All right, just go down in over there, and we'll go out. We gotta get some gas.
We need to get some fuel in her, but I just wanna say, for the first day ever using e-brake, you got around
we
the first-
We almost made it.
We went around the first it. Turn, and you went around the second. You got all the way in to the point where you just need to go straight, spun it up, but that
Next
was perfect.
Time. Next time we're gonna perfect. Be in there.
That was awesome.
Heck yeah. Oh, and Maddie found out the brakes don't work at all.
Yeah, not one bit, guys. One like, bit don't drive this on the street. If you see this, go away from it on the street. I'm not kidding.
I'm kinda terrified.
For the first time ever, I finally felt really, really good behind my car, and check it out.
I can like jump rope in this thing. Nah, it's a little short.
Yes, yes. I know you're like, why, but yes. After a little bit of a lunch break, we got Ricky hopping in the vehicle.
Yeah, what up, boys?
He was at the union doing a little welding for us, you know, so our pipes don't blow up and whatnot.
At the union, getting some welding done, guys.
Jim and Corey and Jarrett, they're all about to try to do some donuts right now, so let's get it going. I mean, I don't think you have to try. I think we know you can do donuts.
Yeah.
All right, up first, we got Jarrett Heitzman. Try to do some donuts right now. That's the cone right now. We've done donuts on the channel for a lot of people before. We're trying to get every single person on the channel to do a donut at some point.
So, I'm ready.
Dude, you gotta... So, all right. Dude, same thing you did before, but you know when you went outside, you lifted the throttle and then you got back into it? Don't lift all the way, lift like a quarter. Or that, whatever, you can do that too.
Alright.
So just stay in it more.
Alright, ready?
Yeah, more juice.
And if you start coming this way again, you better hit them damn brakes, son.
Oh boy, I'm getting out of the way.
No, you're gonna put something. Justin! Ever driven
but that was awesome.
Dude, get in the car. You know how to drive stick?
Yeah.
Alright, thank God. That's step one. Alright. So you're gonna come up to the cone, and as you're inching up to the, like, here's the cone, as you're coming up to the cone this way, you're gonna quick, like, juice the throttle all that you can. The back wheel's gonna kick out, you're gonna let go of the wheel a little bit, the car's gonna rotate, you're gonna grab the wheel a little bit,
clutch in
and then you're gonna really juice it again, and then you're gonna have to figure out the sweet
spot.
Clutch
in or no clutch?
You might have to give it a little clutch kick, a little jabber.
Really, you just get it.
I've never driven a car before, so I'm really not sure.
This is not gonna go well.
What's the worst that could happen? It's not your car.
The only thing that was weird about it was I've never been in, like, I've never been.
That was good. More control. Too much.
When you get in it, you feel the back end kicking out like that,
yeah.
Let off the gas a little bit. Okay. And then once you let off the gas, it'll catch itself, and then you keep going in with the gas. Just flutter it. You got it. Okay. But make sure you go around it first and then do it. Because you're just going so fast into it that you're not even giving yourself a second. Take your time. Go around the cone and then do it.
Yes, Jim! Yes! Yes! You did it! You did it!
Dude, how does it feel that you just did your first donut?
That was sick.
You buying a drift car or what?
I want to. My wife will kill me.
Yeah. Yo, look, this is what I got. That's what I got.
We need God.
You ever seen Indiana Jones?
Halfway. What? The little kid in Indiana Jones that has the wood blocks in the bottom of his feet? That's what Corey needs.
Go get them.
All right, Corey. If you can put it in first gear, you're going to put it in first gear. It depends if the clutch goes all the way out or not. And then you're going to get up to the cone. You're going to circle right next to it. And then you're going to rail in the throttle, get the back end out. Let go of the wheel a little bit. Let the car go out. Grab the wheel again. And then keep a constant, like, three-quarter throttle. You'll go right around the cone.
Okay.
This way, get it again.
Yes, puppy! Yes! 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 Professional drift car driver, Corey, puppy on his bagel. That was awesome.
We had it for a hot second.
That was perfect.
And
it was
then
great.
It got away from us. We got a little too excited.
That was sick.
The helmet's on the roof.
It is. That's how it was for me too. Jim, congrats, you killed it today. Pups.
Yeah, you guys all did good, man.
You killed it. Jarrett, wherever you are, you killed it.
Jarrett.
Yo, what's up, guys? I'm right here. I just got in my brand new Tacoma.
Tundra.
Oh, it's a
Tundra. It's a Tundra. All right, well, it got way darker, way quicker than normal. We're going to call it quits on this one. Thank you so much for you guys watching this one. Remember to subscribe, and peace.